In this video, we'll compare Fiber and GeneHTP frameworks with the Golang standard library and the improved multiplexer added in Go version 1.22. To run the tests, I'll build and deploy these applications to Kubernetes, then measure CPU and memory usage using Prometheus, and we'll visualize everything in Grafana. We'll also compare client-side latency and the number of requests per second each framework can handle. For this test, I increased the number of external clients to generate enough load to force Kubernetes to throttle these applications. And we have a clear winner. To run this test, I created a production-ready Kubernetes cluster in AWS using M6A for extra-large instance types. If you want to learn more, I have a full course on EKS for beginners. Prior to Go 1.22, it was very difficult to develop REST APIs in Go using only Go standard library packages. One primary reason for this difficulty was that HTTP request multiplexer in the standard library didn't support mapping URI patterns with HTTP verbs, which is very important for designing RESTful resources. As a result, many developers eventually turned to the third-party router libraries like this. At this point, you don't really need any third-party web frameworks to build REST API using Golang. You can still use some external compatible middleware to make your life easier, but the standard library now has everything you need. Alright, let's go ahead and deploy applications to Kubernetes and let them run for about 10 to 15 minutes in idle state. It looks like Gene framework uses slightly more memory and CPU to run, while standard library is very close to Fiber. Let's start the test. I'll deploy 20 clients to generate some traffic for each application and gradually increase the number of requests they generate. This test took around 1.5 hours, so I'll compress it into a couple of minutes and show the final results at the end. As you can see, each step takes 5 minutes, and then the number of virtual clients increases. So I would say that every 5 minutes, we add additional 1000 requests per second load to each application. From the start, you can see a trend. Gene uses more CPU and memory to serve requests, and it also has the highest client latency. In the second place, we have the standard library, which is very close to Fiber in terms of resource usage, but has slightly higher latency than Fiber. And in the first place, we have Fiber. It uses less CPU and memory, and its latency is lower compared to the other frameworks. Fiber is based on FastHTP framework, which is why many people don't like to use it. FastHTP is non-standard HTTP implementation focused on speed in specific cases. Unless you need a specific advantages it offers and aware of the risks, it's not a good a default choice. Even official documentation recommends using the standard HTTP library for most use cases. Alright, let's continue and run this test until applications start to fail. As you can see, Gene reached the pod limit defined in Kubernetes first, and Kubernetes started to throttle it, which of course affected performance and increased latency. When running CPU-intensive applications in Kubernetes, make sure to monitor throttling as well. From the requests per second graph, you can see that Gene can only handle around 15,000 requests per second with 2 CPU and 256 MB of memory defined in the pod limit. Next, the standard library started to fail and got throttled by Kubernetes as well. This led for the latency to go up. In this configuration, it seems it can handle only 17,000 requests per second. Let's run it for a few more minutes. Eventually, Fiber also reached its limit at around 20,000 requests per second and started to degrade. Alright, let me go ahead and open each graph separately for the entire duration of the test. First, we have requests per second graph, where you can see how much traffic each application can handle. Next is the latency measured from the client side. Then CPU usage graph. For the throttling, it should be 0 seconds, but since we pushed the apps to the limit, Kubernetes started to throttle them. Finally, we have memory usage graph for each app. So Fiber was the clear winner, but it's not recommended by default for all use cases. In my personal opinion, you should try using standard library for your next Go web or REST application. It has everything you need to get started. If you have any suggestions for improvements in the source code, please raise a PR and I'll definitely merge it and test it. Also, let me know in the comments what you'd like me to test next. I have other benchmarks that you may find interesting. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.